unfortunately, this was the last time that the seniors got to sing with us. But wait, there's one more song. And to introduce this last song for us, I'm going to invite Senior and Chorus President Michelle up to the mic.
Woo! Yeah.
So today is my mother's birthday.
Woo!
She's sitting over there. I won't tell you how old she is because she'll probably yell at me. But just want to let you know, I love you. I hope you're having a wonderful birthday. And we're going to sing for you.
Please join in too.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Shell's mom. Happy birthday to you.
This last little part is to the seniors. Thank you very much for making my year very, very special. Juniors, I will ask you to please leave the stage. Seniors, right up front with me, and we are going to take a very quick senior photo.
Oh my God!
Oh.
How do you do it?
Able to visit. What excitement!
Our little sister, the new goddess, is
You two are just jealous.
Jealous of what? You made Ashton not like a piece of meat?
At least we will be able to marry for love.
Once in bed, away from the presence of her sisters, Psyche laughed with tears of foam.
My beauty's a curse.
Eventually, Psyche was married off to a man. He was a strange man, for he would not let her see his face.
Put your hood on!
Despite this, Psyche fell in love with a mysterious man, until a visit from his sister threatened her happy ending. The next day, there was a knock at the palace doors. When Psyche opened them, her two sisters stood on the front step, rubbing their eyes in wonder.
Psyche! What is this place? Is this really happening?
This is where I've been living these many months.
Psyche explained the mysterious palace and her mysterious husband. When they had first arrived, Psyche's sisters beamed with happiness. But slowly, as they saw the treasures of her new home, they began to scowl once again.
So this husband of yours, he isn't really a beast, is he?
Well, I don't know for sure.
It's an easy question. Either he's a beast or he's not.
Psyche hesitated.
I've never seen his face.
Never seen his face?
You mean he's invisible, like these servants you keep babbling about?
No, he only comes out at midnight. I've never seen him.
You're not allowed to look at his face?
No.
And you love this thing?
I mean, well, yeah.
Oh, Psyche, he obviously is not when we return. I mean, who would keep him when they love prisoners?
If he had a pretty face, then why would he hide it? He's obviously some kind of monster, evil spirit.
I don't know for sure.
That's true, you don't know for sure.
But I don't think...
Thank the gods we came here to talk some sense into you.
You're our darling little sister, Psyche. We wouldn't want you to get hurt.
Psyche hesitated. Her sister pulled a gleaming knife from the folds of her cloak.
Listen to us, Psyche. Tonight while he visits, you must light a lamp and look upon him.
If he's a man, you have nothing to worry about.
But if he's not...
You must end his life before he ends yours.
I...
Sister Tuesday, Don't you want to
come and live with us?
We miss you so, dear sister.
Psyche nodded and the knife was passed into her cold hand. Later on, Psyche said goodbye to her sisters and waited for her husband to return. Psyche followed her sister's advice until she saw the face of her beloved. It was Eros, the god of love. It was too late though. He awoke and upon realizing her deceit, left her. The only way to earn him back was through his mother, the beautiful and powerful Aphrodite. Psyche took a deep breath. The most fearsome mother-in-law heaven and earth had ever seen was waiting for her at the other end of the hallway.
Come in, mortal, don't dilly-dally.
Aphrodite's chamber was all softness and pink. The goddess eyed Psyche coldly.
So, have you come to grovel?
Yes, your majesty.
The goddess paused.
I'm waiting.
Psyche sank to the floor.
Oh, immortal creator of beauty and love, I came to beg your pardon.
I should think so, you little scamp. My son has taken to bed, sick from the wound you gave him. He may not survive.
I didn't mean to.
Silence! And keep grumbling until I tell you to stop.
Forgive me, Majesty.
Why should I? He's dying.
I will do any.
Aphrodite snarled at her.
Silence.
I told her about the pizza.
Did I tell you to speak? Did I tell you to speak?
You told me not to.
Oh. Now, I have devised 3 tasks. If you fail at any, you will never see my son again. But if you succeed, I'll consider forgiving you. Do you accept? Why are you talking?
You told me not to.
Don't be stupid, of course I want you to talk.
I accept.
Marvelous. Let's get to work.
And where she did. Psyche took on 3 difficult tasks given to her by Aphrodite in triumph each time. In the end, Psyche proved her love for Eros, but more importantly, she proved herself as a powerful, determined young woman. The end.
Before I say goodnight for the evening, chorus, please remain on stage so I can take a quick attendance and then send you all out for the evening. Ladies and gentlemen, have a safe drive home. Thank you for coming.